I'm Andrew Bolt, and this is the Bolt Report. At least 80 more boat people drowned this week, lured to their deaths by our criminally weak border laws. This has to be fixed. And this time, let's not be fobbed off with this.
I don't at this stage want to talk about policy or other questions. Our focus now is on the search and rescue effort.
And ignore this too.
It's not a day for politics. It's a day to offer sympathy.
Wrong. This is exactly the time to talk about policy and politics. Now, when we're still angry, before we get apathetic again. 4 years ago, Labor weakened our border laws. Since then, between 600 and 1,000 boat people have been lured to their deaths. For years, Labor lied. It claimed boat people weren't being pulled here by its soft laws, but pushed by wars.
People getting pushed by events around the world.
And they were being pulled by Australia.
Well, I'm not agreeing with that.
Rubbish. The war in Sri Lanka ended years ago. Iraq now is safer. The world hasn't got more dangerous. We've just become softer. Here's the truth. The Howard government's laws, the Pacific Solution, temporary protection visas, had worked. They slashed the number of boats to just 18 in the 6 years before Labor weakened them. But weakening them just tempted people back to the boats.
Keep it rod. He changed everything about refugee. If I go to Australia now, different. Maybe accepted.
The result? Just this month alone, 18 boats have arrived. 18 in not 6 years, but 4 weeks, bringing more than 1,000 people. The flood of boats has cost us billions. It's brought in frauds, like people smuggler Captain Emad, owner of perfume shops in Malaysia.
Captain Emad sent his wife and children to Australia by boat ahead of him in 2009. His wife, three adult children and their dependents all got refugee status.
And with the boats have come the drownings, like the 50 people who died off Christmas Island in 2010. I said then the government had to toughen up and stop the dying. But Greens leader Bob Brown said it was too early to start the blame game with bodies still in the water and I should resign. And when we stopped being angry, the heat died down and nothing was fixed. But boats kept sinking. Last December, up to 200 more boat people drowned. And once again, it was too early to talk about our weak laws, which weren't to blame anyway.
Today is a humanitarian issue. It's not an issue of border security.
Yes, it's always too early to talk about the dead, and now it's too late. Enough. Prime Minister, fix it now. Joining me now from Canberra is Marion Lay, an influential migration agent and refugee advocate. Marion, thanks for your time. The immigration minister now admits one in every 25 boat people drowns trying to get here. That means nearly 800 people, 800, have died since Labor weakened our border laws in 2008. Was that change in our laws a terrible mistake?
Well, I don't think so. I don't like thinking about weakening our border control programs as being part of the manner in which the Labor government dismantled the Pacific Solution, because I think that there were more factors involved in why people began coming again than just simply the dismantling of the Pacific Solution.
So you dispute what refugees have said themselves, or asylum seekers, that they have been attracted by the softer laws. We've played a clip earlier in the show.
Well, I think some people, yes, have been attracted by that, but the reality is that most people, or all the people that I've spoken to who have come by boat, have come because the situation in their own country has been so bad that they haven't been able to stay there and feel safe and secure. And so they figure that, well, it's better to take their chances. When they get to Malaysia and Indonesia, they find that they're being stockpiled. They might be registered as refugees by the UNHCR and told, well, you will be resettled eventually in Australia. But many of them are staying there for up to 6, 7, 8 years while they wait for resettlement. So they decide, look, we can't just put our lives on hold in this way. We're not safe here either. And so they take the chance of getting in these very, very flimsy, unseaworthy vessels and coming to Australia.
So 800 people dead, is that just one of the prices you pay for having a more attractive asylum seeker policy?
Look, anyone dead is a disaster as far as I'm concerned. And we could do comparison, say, with the Indochinese refugees, where at that time, back in the 70s, the UNHCR said that they believed that only 10% of all boats setting out actually made it. And of those 10% of boats, another 10% at least were boarded and the women were raped or taken away.
Yeah, but we're not looking at that situation now, Marion.
Well,
it seems a very organised kind of trade, maybe closer to illegal immigration than desperation.
Well, I think, again, you know, we can draw these comparisons because if people are desperate enough, they will do desperate things and they will take desperate measures. Now, I don't agree at all that people should be having to get into these boats, and I do believe that anyone that overcrowds boats in the manner that this one apparently was should be liable for prosecution. And not everybody in the refugee so-called advocacy groups would agree with me, and perhaps I'll probably get a bit of flack for saying that, because some people believe that people have the right, and they do, to take their lives in their own hands and make decisions. Everyone getting on that boat presumably made the decision to do so, and I understand that it was not very long offshore from Indonesia before the alarm was raised that it was unseaworthy. But again, people made decisions to continue on, even though the Australian government apparently, the Australian Coastal Guard apparently warned them to turn back.
And they didn't turn back and they drowned.
Look, and they didn't.
Look, maybe you're right that it's fundamentally their choice to risk their lives. I'm not so sure about that we don't have a responsibility. But listen, how to stop it? People swap? The Malaysian people swap? Is that the go?
No, I thought that was people trading, and I was totally against that. I don't believe that you should make 800 people chosen at random sort of the trading post for other people, bringing 4,000 here for an 800 people swap. I've never ever understood that at all.
But
it just seems
work?
Ludicrous.
But would it work?
I don't think that would work. What I think will work is if everyone comes to the table, sits down together, the opposition, hopefully some of the opposition backbenchers now will actually take to Tony Abbott the suggestion that it is time to really sit down and talk this thing through, not just with the Labor government, but everyone needs to be talking, the UNHCR, other people such as, I guess, myself, people who've been involved in this situation or these situations for years. We need to sit down, come to the table and talk about a durable solution, one that will work, which is what Tony Abbott is saying. We need one that will work, and put it in place with Indonesia, with Malaysia and the countries of the region.
Yeah,
and
we but also Marion, need to be... look, all the talking and people are still dying, but I agree with you. We do need to fix this, and now, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Andrew.